Ladies and gentlemen, will you please rise for the national anthems of the United States of America and the Federal Republic of Germany?
Should be a fly line.
Up! Information!
Herr Präsident, Soldaten der amerikanischen Streitkräfte, Soldaten der Bundeswehr, Exzellenzen, meine sehr verehrten Damen und Herren, liebe amerikanische Freunde, liebe Landsleute, es geschieht nicht oft, dass uns die geschichtliche Verstrickung der Vergangenheit in Gegenwart und Zukunft unseres Landes so eindrücklich erreicht wie in diesen Stunden hier in Bitburg. Der Präsident der Vereinigten Staaten von Amerika, unser Freund Ronald Reagan und ich haben vor wenigen Minuten dort drüben auf dem Soldatenfriedhof der dort liegenden Toten gedacht und mit ihnen aller Opfer des Krieges und der Gewaltherrschaft, der Toten und der Verfolgten aller Nationen. Der Gang mit Präsident Reagan über die Soldatengräber von Bitburg war kein leichter Gang. Er musste und muss bei vielen tiefe Empfindungen wachrufen. Für mich bedeutet er zunächst und ganz unmittelbar Trauer und Betroffenheit über das unendliche Leid, das Krieg und totalitäres Regime über die Völker gebracht haben. Trauer und Betroffenheit, die nie vergehen werden. Aber aus ihr erwächst für uns die Verpflichtung zum Frieden in Freiheit als oberstes Ziel unseres politischen Handelns. Und dieser Gang zu den Gräbern von Bitburg bedeutet auch eine Bekräftigung und eine weithin sichtbare und empfundene Geste der Aussöhnung zwischen unseren Völkern, dem Volk der Vereinigten Staaten und uns Deutschen. Eine Aussöhnung, die die Vergangenheit nicht verdrängt, sondern sie miteinander überwindet. Und schließlich ist unser Hiersein die Bewährung einer Freundschaft, die sich als standfest und verlässlich erwiesen hat und die sich auf dem Wissen um gemeinsame Wertordnungen gründet. Ich danke Ihnen, Herr Präsident, für das ganze deutsche Volk und ich danke Ihnen sehr persönlich als Freund, dass Sie diesen Gang mit mir gemeinsam gemacht haben. Ich glaube, dass viele in unserem deutschen Volk diesen Ausdruck tiefer Freundschaft verstehen und dass uns daraus für unsere Völker gemeinsam gute Zukunft erwachsen wird. Die Stadt Bitburg war in besonderer Weise Zeuge des Unterganges des Dritten Reiches. Sie hat das Jahr 1945 erlitten und sie hat den Anschluss gefunden im Wiederaufbau in den Jahren der Versöhnung. Hier in Bitburg finden seit 25 Jahren gemeinsame Gedenkfeiern statt, in denen sich amerikanische, französische und deutsche Soldaten und die Bürger dieser Stadt und dieser Region der Opfer des Krieges erinnern und ihre Freundschaft und ihren Willen, gemeinsam für das Erhalten des Friedens einzutreten, immer wieder neu bekräftigen. Hier haben sich in besonderer Weise in diesen Jahren engste freundschaftliche Beziehungen zwischen den amerikanischen Streitkräften und unserer Bevölkerung entwickelt. Bitburg kann als ein Symbol der Aussöhnung und der deutsch-amerikanischen Freundschaft gelten. Soldaten der Bundeswehr. Die meisten von Ihnen sind nach dem 8. Mai 1945 geboren. Sie haben Krieg und Zwangsherrschaft in unserem Land selbst nicht mehr kennengelernt. Sie sind aufgewachsen in der Zeit des Baus unserer Republik. In der Zeit, in der die Freundschaft zwischen uns und dem amerikanischen Volk sich wiederbelebte und entwickelte. Sie haben unsere amerikanischen Freunde als Helfer, als Partner und als Verbündete kennengelernt. Tage wie der heutige sind geeignet, gerade die junge Generation unseres Volkes daran zu erinnern, dass diese für uns so glückliche Entwicklung nicht selbstverständlich ist und dass das Erhalten von Frieden in Freiheit unseren ganz persönlichen Einsatz fordert. Sie, die Soldaten der amerikanischen Streitkräfte in der Bundesrepublik Deutschland, dienen in Ihrem Lande, den Vereinigten Staaten von Amerika und unserer Republik gleichermaßen. Die Sicherheit der Bundesrepublik Deutschland ist aufs Engste mit der Partnerschaft, mit der Freundschaft, mit den Vereinigten Staaten von Amerika verbunden. Wir wissen, was wir Ihnen und auch Ihren Familien verdanken. Wir wissen auch, dass für viele von Ihnen der Dienst in Übersee Opfer bedeutet. Seien Sie gewiss, dass Sie in unserem Land, in der Bundesrepublik Deutschland, gern gesehene Gäste sind. Und lassen Sie sich auch von einer kleinen, unbedeutenden Minderheit anderes nicht einreden. Sie sind uns von Herzen willkommen als Freunde, als Verbündete, als Garanten unserer Sicherheit. Die Beziehungen zwischen den amerikanischen Streitkräften und der Bundeswehr sind über viele Jahre hinweg gewachsen und eng wie nie zuvor. Ich möchte Ihnen, den amerikanischen und den deutschen Soldaten, danken für diese für uns schon fast selbstverständlich gewordene Partnerschaft. Sie stärkt unseren gemeinsamen Willen zur Verteidigung und Frieden und Freiheit unserer Länder. Und diese Partnerschaft, und auch das will ich gerade hier in Bitburg erwähnen, ist so eine Quelle des gegenseitigen Verständnisses unserer Völker geworden, eine Quelle und Begründung für viele persönliche Freundschaften. Ich wünsche Ihnen, den Soldaten der amerikanischen Streitkräfte, ich wünsche unseren Soldaten der Bundeswehr, ich wünsche uns allen, dass wir gemeinsam unseren Beitrag zum Frieden und zur Freiheit unseres Landes, zum Frieden in der Welt leisten mögen und dass Gottes Segen uns geschenkt sein möge.
Thank you very much. I have just come from the cemetery where German war dead lay at rest. No one could visit there without deep and conflicting emotions. I felt great sadness that history could be filled with such waste, destruction, and evil. But my heart was also lifted by the knowledge that from the ashes has come hope, and that from the terrors of the past we have built 40 years of peace, freedom, and reconciliation among our nations. This visit has stirred many emotions in the American and German people, too. I've received many letters since first deciding to come to Bitburg Cemetery. Some supportive, others deeply concerned and questioning, and others opposed. Some old wounds have been reopened, and this I regret very much, because this should be a time of healing. To the veterans and families of American servicemen who still carry the scars and feel the painful losses of that war, our gesture of reconciliation with the German people today in no way minimizes our love and honor for those who fought and died for our country. They gave their lives to rescue freedom in its darkest hour. The alliance of democratic nations that guards the freedom of millions in Europe and America today stands as living testimony that their noble sacrifice was not in vain. No, their sacrifice was not in vain. I have to tell you that nothing will ever fill me with greater hope than the sight of two former war heroes who met today at the Bitburg ceremony, each among the bravest of the brave, each an enemy of the other 40 years ago, each a witness to the horrors of war. But today they came together, American and German, General Matthew B. Ridgway and General Johannes Steinhoff, reconciled and united for freedom. They reached over the graves to one another like brothers and grasped their hands in peace. To the survivors of the Holocaust, your terrible suffering has made you ever vigilant against evil. Many of you are worried that reconciliation means forgetting. Well, I promise you, we will never forget. I have just come this morning from Bergen-Belsen, where the horror of that terrible crime, the Holocaust, was forever burned upon my memory. No, we will never forget. And we say with the victims of that Holocaust, never again. The war against one man's totalitarian dictatorship was not like other wars. The evil war of Nazism turned all values upside down. Nevertheless, we can mourn the German war dead today as human beings crushed by a vicious ideology. There are over 2,000 buried in Bitburg Cemetery. Among them are 48 members of the SS. The crimes of the SS must rank among the most heinous in human history. But others buried there were simply soldiers in the German army. How many were fanatical followers of a dictator and willfully carried out his cruel orders? And how many were conscripts forced into service during the death throes of the Nazi war machine? We do not know. Many, however, we know from the dates on their tombstones were only teenagers at the time. There is one boy buried there who died a week before his 16th birthday. There were thousands of such soldiers to whom Nazism meant no more than a brutal end to a short life. We do not believe in collective guilt. Only God can look into the human heart. And all these men have now met their supreme judge, and they have been judged by him as we shall all be judged. Our duty today is to mourn the human wreckage of totalitarianism, and today in Bitburg Cemetery, we commemorated the potential good and humanity that was consumed back then, 40 years ago. Perhaps if that 15-year-old soldier had lived, he would have joined his fellow countrymen in building this new Democratic Federal Republic of Germany, devoted to human dignity and the defense of freedom that we celebrate today. Or perhaps his children or his grandchildren might be among you here today at the Bitburg Air Base, where new generations of Germans and Americans join together in friendship and common cause, dedicating their lives to preserving peace and guarding the security of the free world. Too often in the past, each war only planted the seeds of the next. We celebrate today the reconciliation between our two nations that has liberated us from that cycle of destruction. Look at what together we've accomplished. We who were enemies are now friends. We who were bitter adversaries are now the strongest of allies. In the place of fear, we've sown trust, and out of the ruins of war has blossomed an enduring peace. Tens of thousands of Americans have served in this town over the years. As the mayor of Bitburg has said, in that time there have been some 6,000 marriages between Germans and Americans, and many thousands of children have come from these unions. This is the real symbol of our future together, a future to be filled with hope, friendship, and freedom. The hope that we see now could sometimes even be glimpsed in the darkest days of the war. I'm thinking of one special story, that of a mother and her young son living alone in a modest cottage in the middle of the woods. And one night, as the Battle of the Bulge exploded not far away and around them, three young American soldiers arrived at their door. They were standing there in the snow, lost behind enemy lines. All were frostbitten. One was badly wounded. Even though sheltering the enemy was punishable by death, she took them in and made them a supper with some of her last food. And then they heard another knock at the door. And this time, four German soldiers stood there. The woman was afraid, but she quickly said with a firm voice, "There will be no shooting here." She made all the soldiers lay down their weapons, and they all joined in the makeshift meal. Hans and Willy, it turned out, were only 16. The corporal was the oldest at 23. Their natural suspicion dissolved in the warmth and the comfort of the cottage. One of the Germans, a former medical student, tended the wounded American. But now listen to the rest of the story through the eyes of one who was there, now a grown man, but that young lad that had been her son. He said, "The mother said grace. I noticed that there were tears in her eyes of war. Surely we allies in peacetime should honor the reconciliation of the last 40 years. To the people of Bitburg, our hosts and the hosts of our servicemen, like that generous woman 40 years ago, you make us feel very welcome. Viel en dank." And to the men and women of Bitburg Air Base, I just want to say that we know that even with such wonderful hosts, your job is not an easy one. You serve around the clock, far from home, always ready to defend freedom. We're grateful, and we're very proud of you. Four decades ago, we waged a great war to lift the darkness of evil from the world, to let men and women in this country and in every country live in the sunshine of liberty. Our victory was great, and the Federal Republic, Italy, and Japan are now in the community of free nations. But the struggle for freedom is not complete. For today, much of the world is still cast in totalitarian darkness. 22 years ago, President John F. Kennedy went to the Berlin Wall and proclaimed that he too was a Berliner. Well, today, freedom-loving people around the world must say, "I am a Berliner. I am a Jew in a world still threatened by anti-Semitism. I am an Afghan, and I am a prisoner of the Gulag. I am a refugee in a crowded boat foundering off the coast of Vietnam. I am a Laotian, a Cambodian, a Cuban, and a Mosquito Indian in Nicaragua. I, too, am a potential victim of totalitarianism." The one lesson of World War II, the one lesson of Nazism, is that freedom must always be stronger than totalitarianism, and that good must always be stronger than evil. The moral measure of our two nations will be found in the resolve we show to preserve liberty, to protect life, and to honor and cherish all God's children. That is why the Free Democratic Federal Republic of Germany is such a profound and hopeful testament to the human spirit. We cannot undo the crimes and wars of yesterday, nor call back the millions back to life. But we can give meaning to the past by learning its lessons and making a better future. We can let our pain drive us to greater efforts to heal humanity's suffering. Today I've traveled 220 miles from Bergen-Belsen, and I feel 40 years in time. With the lessons of the past firmly in our minds, we've turned a new, brighter page in history. One of the many who wrote me about this visit was a young woman who had recently been bat mitzvahed. She urged me to lay the wreath at Bitburg Cemetery in honor of the future of Germany. And that is what we've done. On this 40th anniversary of World War II, we mark the day when the hate, the evil, and the obscenities ended. And we commemorate the rekindling of the democratic spirit in Germany. There's much to make us hopeful on this historic anniversary. One of the symbols of that hate, or that could have been that hope, a little while ago, when we heard a German band playing the American National Anthem and an American band playing the German National Anthem. While much of the world still huddles in the darkness of oppression, we can see a new dawn of freedom sweeping the globe. And we can see in the new democracies of Latin America, in the new economic freedoms and prosperity in Asia, in the slow movement toward peace in the Middle East, and in the strengthening alliance of democratic nations in Europe and America, that the light from that dawn is growing stronger. Together, let us gather in that light and walk out of the shadow. Let us live in peace. Thank you. And God bless you all.